Hey everybody, and welcome back to another episode of 7-Minute AE Tutorials, where you learn AE tips, tricks, and shortcuts in less than 7 minutes. No BS, just AE. In this episode, I'm going to show you how to create a simple, flat, robotic machine with moving parts. You'll learn some basics about how to parent layers, as well as how to use the slider control to your advantage. This project is another example of just how powerful shape layers are in After Effects. There's a lot to get through, so let's get right to it. Let's create a new composition, and let's make it 500 by 500. And this is going to be our tire for a robotic machine. So first, let's right-click New Shape Layer, and we want to add a group. And let's name this group Middle. We're going to add an ellipse and give that ellipse a fill. So let's make the fill like a dark gray. Okay, so let's add another group. And to this group, we want to add a polystar and a fill. And let's make that fill black. Now, this is going to be our tire. And then the tire is going to have some tread on it. So that's why I used a polystar. So for the points, let's go with 12 points. We'll do the inner radius at 100, outer radius at 105. We want our inner roundness to be 75 and our outer roundness to be 245. So see, we kind of have this tire with a little bit of tread on it. Duplicate this middle group and we'll name this center. And let's open that up to the transform properties and just reduce the size of that. You can change this fill to a darker gray, almost black. And then I want to give this thing some lug nuts. Duplicate this group we've called center. Rename that lug nuts. So let's move the lug nuts up using our transform properties to about right where we want it. And let's decrease the scale on that. We want to add a repeater, and we're going to put this repeater underneath our lug nuts, but above center. Okay. And as you can see, it already pops up. It gives us three copies. We want six. And let's go into the transform properties of the repeater. And for rotation, let's type in 360 divided by six. And let's make our anchor point and our position all zeros. And see, so it pops in as a perfect circle here. So let's change the name of middle to rim. And, you know, maybe we'll make this a little bit lighter. We can increase the size of this just a little bit. Maybe something kind of like that. So there's our tire. Okay, so now let's create a new composition. So Control N. And this is going to be our robot. And we want to do HDTV 1080 2997 preset. Now, the reason why this background looks pink is because I've gone into composition settings and you can change the background to whatever color you want. Normally, it's set to black. I have it set to a lighter red. You can make it whatever color you want. Let's bring in our tire. Okay, so let's move this down here. Let's make this a little bit smaller. Let's duplicate the tire, Control D, and just move it over. And now let's start to build our robot. So let's go layer, new, shape layer. We want to add a rectangle. And give that rectangle both a fill and a stroke, something kind of like that. And then I want my stroke to be just a darker version of that. So I'm going to take my eyedropper and click on my fill here and then just kind of drag down my color to kind of get something for an outline. First, let's pull it down using our transform properties. Whenever I work with shape layers, I like to use the transform properties of the shape layer for positioning as opposed to the positioning in the rectangle path. And the reason why is because you maintain your anchor point when you use the transform properties. See, if I use the position up here, the rectangle path, it gets away from my anchor point and I can reposition it, but there's really no reason to do that. So let's go about in between our tires here. Now I do use this, the sizing of the rectangle path quite a bit. So let's unlink that and let's stretch it out. And then just crank up this roundness until it's completely rounded there. Okay, and now let's take our mask tool for a rectangle. Make sure that you click this option here, tool creates mask, as opposed to tool creates shape. If you use tool creates mask, you can mask out a shape layer. Draw a mask over this and kind of cut it right there through the middle of the tire. Okay, now it's gonna be really important to make sure you name these shape layers. This is gonna be the main part of our robot and everything is gonna be linked to this main, including our tires. And we can go ahead and link that right now to our main. Highlight main and Control D to duplicate it. Let's hit M to bring up our mask and just get rid of that. And let's bring this underneath and I'm gonna call this main connector. And let's just kind of play around with our settings here. So for the rectangle path, first let's take off our roundness, make this narrower, open up our transform properties and move it up. So let's click on stroke. If you hit control C, it automatically copies your color. So let's go into fill, control V, and now let's hit our stroke. And now let's make the stroke a little bit darker. So basically I want my outlines to be a little bit darker. Control D, our main connector. And now let's make our fill the same color as our main. And let's bring up our position, move it above our main connector. Let's open up our contents and let's go a little bit wider, maybe have a little bit of roundness to it. Let's make our stroke consistent with the rest of the project. So this color here, remember, is the color of the stroke for the lighter shades. So I'm going to go ahead and choose that color. Actually, let's name this body. So let's control D, this main connector. Hit P to bring up our position and let's move it up here and open up our contents. And we're going to make this even narrower. Move this up a little bit. And now we'll call this connector 2. Okay, let's add another shape layer. And this time we want to add an ellipse. And again, give that ellipse a fill and a stroke. And we're going to use the same colors as we've been using. Make our stroke darker brown. Okay, now let's move our ellipse to about right here. And we want to increase the scaling, increase our stroke a little bit. Call this circle 1. With contents highlighted, let's add a group. And let's just pull all of this into that group. Okay, so now we can duplicate group 1. And we have another ellipse. And let's go into the transform properties and just decrease the scaling. And then let's reverse these colors. So we want the fill to be this darker. And actually, we don't want to reverse it completely. We want the stroke to be the darker stroke. So if you click on stroke again, control C copies the color. Then we can go back up to this circle here. Go to our stroke, control V, and it pops it right in there. Actually, what I want to do here is I want to reverse these as well. Okay, let's just increase this stroke and let's move the fill on top of our stroke here. Let's grab this connector 2 and hit control D. Let's bring up our position and rotation. Just move it over 270 for our rotation. We'll open up our contents here and play around with our sizing of our rectangle path. Be long and narrow. And let's increase our roundness to kind of get that round edge there. Now, this is where it's really important that you pay attention to your anchor point. So let's move this arm to where it wraps around this inner ellipse here. And we want to hit Y to grab our pan around tool and drag over. And if you hit control, it'll snap right to that point right there. So we want it to be right there. Duplicate our circle 1, bring up our positioning and scale. We move it down to the end of the arm and let's just make this whole circle smaller. So this is like another joint here. Maybe we'll make this connector a little thinner. And now we can take this connector 3, control D, and bring up our position and rotation. And click Y to bring up your pan around tool. And we want this anchor point to be at the opposite end. So hold on control and it'll pop right in there. And then let's rotate this out, reposition this a little bit. And let's open up our content settings for the rectangle path for connector 4. And let's shorten this up. Click Y to grab your pan around tool again. Control to pop it in right there. Let's bring these arms to the middle of our circles instead. That way it's going to radiate from the middle. The same thing for connector 3. All right. And then let's duplicate circle 2. Bring up our positioning and scaling. Let's bring it down and make this one, again, even smaller. It's going to be kind of like the wrist. Okay, now let's make a new shape layer. And let's add a rectangle and a fill. And let's make this fill medium brown here. Okay, we're going to pull it over to this circle. And let's kind of play with the settings on this. Basically, I'm going to be making pincers. Let's go into contents. We're going to add a group. Put this rectangle and fill into that group. Now we can duplicate that group 1. We can rotate this out. Actually, let's make this 135 rotation and let's make group 2. We'll make that rotation 45. We have this group 1 and we're going to just connect it to the edge right here. And so let's call this left pincher. Put the anchor point. If you click Y, it brings up your pan around tool and bring it to this corner here. So control, and it'll pop right there on the corner. Make sure this is behind your circle 3. Bring up your position and rotation. Put this about in the middle there. So now let's control D our left pincher and let's rename this right pincher. And now if you right click on right pincher and you go to transform, flip horizontal, it'll just flip your pincher. So that way it's facing the opposite direction and you can kind of play with that to make sure it's about right. That's it for the most part. Like I said, it's a very basic robot, but I'm going to show you how to link this up to make this thing move around. We want our pincers to be connected to this circle 3 here. So all of these layers are going to be connected to our main right here, to track 6. So let's change the color of that to, we'll say yellow. Everything is going to connect back to our main layer here, layer 6. So let's highlight right pincher, left pincher, and connect that to circle 3. Circle 3 is going to be connected to this arm right here, which is connector 4. Okay, and then connector 4 is going to be connected to this circle 2 right here. So we're just kind of working backwards. So everything's connected. I'm going to connect this to connector 3. Connector 3 is going to be connected to circle 1. Circle 1 is going to be connected to connector 2. Connector 2 is going to be connected to our body. The body is going to be connected to the main connector. And then our main connector is going to be connected to our main. The reason why we did that is if you bring up the position for the main layer, wherever you move this, everything moves along with it. Let's bring up our scale as well. And let's just kind of reduce the size so I can get some movements in here. Okay, so we want these tires to move wherever our robot moves, but we want it to be exact. So like if it's going slowly or if it slides in fast, we want it to be accurate. And the way we can do that is let's go to our tire here and we're going to type in, already have it up, but type in slider and you get the slider control. So if you bring in the slider control, put it on our tire layer, let's open that up. And you want to connect the slider control to the positioning of our main layer. And the way you do that is holding down Alt, click the slider, and you just want to pick whip the position. In the same tire layer, we're going to bring up our rotation, Alt click on the stopwatch for rotation, and we're going to pick whip this to our slider control. Okay, so now what you end up having, just watch this tire here. However you move, it's going to move with it. So that's pretty cool. And then just go down to our other tire layer, R for rotation, Alt click the stopwatch and again pick whip this to the slider and our slider control. Both of our tires are moving. And the thing that's kind of cool about this, let's just do a couple of quick keyframes. Let's put one here and then say go about 2 seconds and we go just to the other side. So if you hit Shift F9, you get an ease in, go to your graph editor and let's kind of really start it fast and slide it in slowly. You can see that the tires stay with it the whole time. So you see how the tires move exactly with it. And, you know, as it goes backwards, they'll move in the opposite direction. So that's a pretty cool trick, I think. You can do all kinds of things with this robot. You can move it anywhere you want. You can put a background in there. You know, you can move around all of these arms, hit R for rotation. And now see, as you turn it around, everything moves with it. Put a keyframe there. Maybe go about 3.5 or just after 3 seconds and you want to rotate it this way. And at the same time that's happening, you know, these circles are going to be like really where your main movements are going to be coming from. So let's change those to those track layers to, we'll say purple. So hit R to bring up the rotation on those and set some keyframes. Maybe you want it to go the opposite direction. You want this one to go something like that. And you can offset these however you want to get whatever movement you want. So as it's moving around, you know, you can move the arm around however you want. If you go to the last keyframe and click position, it highlights both your keyframes. So now you can pull this down and without messing up your movement there. I just want to kind of bring it down so that way the arm doesn't go off screen. It still is. So let's kind of reduce our scaling here so that way our arm doesn't go off screen. Let's fit this in there. Okay, so now to make these pincers move, let's go to our right pincher, and again, we're going to bring in a slider control. Let's hit E for effects, Shift R for rotation. And as you can see, our anchor point is right here, right where we want it at this corner. And let's Alt-click rotation and pick whip that to the slider. So now as the slider moves, it affects the rotation. And what we're going to do for our left pincher, click R for rotation, Alt-click our rotation, and we want to pick whip the slider. We want to go the opposite direction. So see, as it is right now, they're moving together. We want them to pinch together. So for this second slider on our left pincher, go to the very end of the script and type in asterisk, and that's for multiply, -1. So basically, it's just going to do the opposite of what the right pincher will do. So see, as we open it, close it. We kind of have that kind of movement. And, you know, you don't really want to go much beyond zero because you start to overlap. But say if zero is your ending point, you can set a keyframe there and maybe open it up a little bit and hit zero. So you kind of, I mean, this is just very, very basic kind of movements that I'm doing here. You can add in other arms. You can add in more pincers. You can put a background behind it and add in a whole warehouse setting if you wanted. I just kind of filled in the background with kind of like a warehouse kind of setting right here. Here's a little trick you can do. If you just want this robot to go back and forth, if you alt click the position, click this little arrow here and go to property loop out cycle. And actually you need to come back. So take this first keyframe, copy and paste it, put about an equal distance somewhere in between these two. And you know, this will just kind of move around indefinitely. It's a little boring, but you kind of get the idea, and you get you can see how the tires are moving back and forth with the robot. And again, you know, there's a lot you can do with these arms. You know, just kind of have fun with it. You can do some cool things. As it's moving, you can move them in time with one another, or you can offset them to kind of get a cooler kind of look. Maybe for the pinchers, if you go to, actually go to the slider control, take this first keyframe, control C, control V to copy and paste. So that way we have these three keyframes here. Alt click the slider and hit this arrow. Again, we can do a loop out cycle and it will just pinch nonstop. Something like that. And you know, if you want to pinch faster, bring these keyframes in closer together. So just a few cool tricks you learn about parenting using the slider control is very, very useful in an example like this, where you want the tires to move along with something, loop out cycle to do things like pinching and to keep things moving constantly. When I upload this project file, it will have these windows and these boxes in there, which also were created using shape layers. These windows will make them peach, and these are all boxes, so I'll make that pink. So everything in this project file was used creating shape layers. The floor and the background were solids, but you know, if you really wanted to make those shape layers as well, you could. A little basic robot there, kind of cool. Hopefully you can use it in one of your projects. Let me know in the comments below if you dig this. Thanks. I hope this helped you out. Please subscribe, like, share, and comment. Let me know in the comments below if there's anything you'd like to see and if this episode was helpful. I'm uploading the project file, so be sure to check it out and use it for your own projects. Thanks, everybody, and we'll see you next time.